surfactants, fragrance, and detergents. These were the ingredients chosen to create the perfect cleaner, but Dr. G wisely added polymers. Thus, the Optimum Rinseless Washes were born. Using their super cleaning powers, O&R, Wash & Wax, and Opticoat No-Rinse have dedicated their lives to fighting grime and the forces of Mari.
Hey guys, Levi for the Rag Company. And in today's video, we're going to be talking about the history of O&R. Optimum No-Rinse, or as we call it, O&R, was developed in 2006 by Dr. David Ghodoussi. And Dr. G, as he is referred to, said he developed O&R to be an alternative to traditional soap and water washing. So I started using O&R in my own shop, gosh, almost 10 years ago, longer than that. Holy cow, it's been almost 15 years, but it wasn't until 2015 that I actually got to start hanging out with Ivan LaCroix and actively learning and deep diving into O&R itself. So the first stop on our rinseless journey is, well, one we have to go back in time for. Back to when Ivan and I were gonna show you how rinseless wash works.
With me, Mr. Ivan LaCroix from Optimum Polymer Technologies. How are you, my friend?
Great, glad to be here.
Good to see you again.
You're basically known as Mr. O&R.
A bit, yeah, a little. I like the stuff.
That's right.
Yeah.
My favorite product in the Optimum line, as everybody knows, is Optimum No-Rinse, commonly known as O&R. O&R is a substantive polymer that really does a lot of great things. You'll notice I only have one bucket. You don't need a two-bucket wash. You don't need that rinse bucket. O&R, because of the polymers, because of the way it works, drops all the dirt right to the bottom of the bucket, out of your way, below your grit guard. So what O&R does, first of all, the polymers in O&R encapsulate the dirt, lifting it off the surface with the Zewitter ionic nature.
Yeah.
And it's emulsifying the dirt before you even touch the vehicle. Zewitter ionic is a German term. It's never been translated to other languages, but it means neither negative nor positive.
When we were kids, we'd take some magnets and try to put the two positives or two negatives together, and we could never quite get them together. That's what O&R is. It's lifting the dirt on a microscopic ionic cushion, keeping it away from the paint. And finally, the polymers are leaving behind a little bit of residue on the paint. Now, every time you wash with O&R, you're not applying new residue. It's actually reliquefying the residue that you left on the paint previously. So when you left that residue on the paint previously, you're re-wetting it, it's helping the dirt come off. So when you wash your car with O&R the first time, you're gonna be amazed. When you wash it the second time, it's even better.
And finally, the lubrication. Soap and water lubricates a little bit. O&R lubricates a lot. And the big difference with O&R is that lubrication stays there at all times. When we're washing with soap and water, we use the soap and water, we wash the car, and what do? We rinse it away with water. Now we're left with water on the vehicle, which is a solvent. That solvent has a high surface tension, and you're trying to dry with a solvent on the car. Now we're drying with a polymer. Don't wash your car with an antique technology like soap and water. Use a modern polymer to wash your modern paints.
The next stop on our rinseless journey is the present, which means for that, we got to talk to the man who created it himself, Dr. G.
My background includes working over 45 years in chemistry labs, 23 of which is at Optimum Polymer and Opticoat. Before starting Opti, I worked in manufacturing clear coat paint for DuPont and PPG. A few professional detailers came to me and asked if I could make a car wash product that they can use with 1 to 2 gallons of water due to their state requirements. Based on my background in polymer chemistry, I designed a substantive polymer that has the ability to encapsulate dirt to act as a barrier between dirt particles and clear coat paint, as well as the ability to take all the dirt out of solution. Otherwise, you would be putting dirty water back on the car while washing it. O&R is for anyone with a dirty car. It works easier than washing with soap and is a more powerful cleaner. We also realized from the beginning that O&R is much more than a car cleaning solution and can be used for many uses inside and outside of the car, such as glass cleaner, clay lube, quick detailer, waterless wash, interior cleaner, as well as many home uses. The secret in O&R is the polymers that encapsulate dirt and remove them from the bucket. We have shown this via lab experiments, but you can also see it whenever you use O&R in a bucket, since all the dirt drops to the bottom and the solution stays clear. In 2005, we went through many versions of ONR before we had the final formula ready for release in 2006. Since then, ONR has gone through 5 major revisions, and the latest one is in 2023. In the meantime, we have also added NORINSE Wash and Wax, Optical NORINSE, and Hyperform NORINSE. To maximize the efficiency of NORINSE, I maximized the concentration of ONR to require only minimal product in the washing process. This makes NORINSE very economical while reducing shipping costs and packaging needs. 19 years later, some of those original testers served as testers for the new ONR Hyperform. It was when I sent the samples to several highly knowledgeable detailers and they asked me if I could sell them ONR by the gallon. I think at Optimum, we think mostly outside the box. We always have some new products or product revisions in the works, and that goes for ONR as well, which has gone through 5 revisions in the past 18 years. I look at detailing as a great profession, which has come a long ways in the past 23 years while I've been involved with the industry. I have many great friends in this industry that help me with their ideas and their knowledge and continue to give me ideas to work on and keep it challenging. Many of them are also true masters of the art, and I enjoy looking at their work whenever I get a chance.
Oh, hey, I didn't see you there. I was just organizing some ONR here on the shelf. Now that we've talked about the past, the present, it's only right that we talk about the future of ONR and the future of rinseless washing. As it sits right now in 2024, we have several great rinseless competitors out on the market, and there's been many other competitors that have come and gone. Some have built up some massive hype and then they just kind of fell off. And then others did something different, right? Maybe they provided more slickness. Maybe they provided more cleaning power in comparison to the king right here, and it made them stand out. But what I'm trying to say here is that the comparison is always to ONR because it was the original. It was one of the best, and people are always trying to achieve what this continues to do, and they're trying to achieve it in ways that maybe could be better. And so I think that there's some good honorable mentions out there, right? KCX Rapid Rinseless Wash, pretty good, right? DIY Detail, it's okay. Absolute Rinseless Wash, pretty good. McKee's 914, not bad. Armor Detail Supply Hero, also pretty good. So needless to say, there's been some new rinseless washes coming out that have done a really good job. But again, this is the standard, right? It's always been the standard. And if the standard has never been good enough for you, I hope you guys know there's other varieties of Optimum NORINSE. There's ONR Wash and Shine, the original. There's ONR Wash and Wax, which is gonna have a little bit of wax in it, making it a little bit slicker. Some people don't know that exists. There's also the OptiCoat version, also adding a little protection and adding some slickness as well. And ultimately that bottle looks pretty cool and it also smells pretty good as well. But what I'm trying to say here is that the market for rinseless washing is changing and more brands are catching on to how many people actually prefer rinseless washing. So there's other brands and other major brands that are currently working on rinseless washes right now to compete with the market and ultimately use this right here as the benchmark, right? It's never changed. It's always been Optimum NORINSE. So with that said, I think we got to talk about what rinseless washing has done for myself, what it's done for Levi Gates. I think we need to make one more stop. All right, so we've arrived to our final stop and we've reached our destination here, which is what ONR has actually done for us as detailers and enthusiasts. So Levi, how has ONR changed your life?
Well, thank you for asking, Anthony. When I had my shop, utilizing rinseless technology, utilizing the synergistic opportunities of ONR allowed me to save a bunch of money in my shop on chemicals because I was able to use ONR for up to 5 items in my shop.
Amazing.
Meaning I could wash, I could use it as a clay lube, I could use it as a glass cleaner. We were using it to help wipe off compound and polishes in there. And then we used it for light interior cleaning. Simple, easy, crazily effective. It made my guys way more efficient and made me more money. Now, in my personal life, what it allowed me to do is allow me to actually wash cars with my kids and actually have fun doing it because I didn't have to deal with the stress of leaving soap on my car or
direct sunlight, right?
Having my kids spray me with a foam cannon. I literally could just give him a spray bottle. Hey, spray this panel. When he was 3, when he was 10.
Beautifully said, Levi. I'm really glad we made this stop.
I am too. How did it work from your end?
Well, Levi, it helped with my stress levels, right? Because washing can be a stressful thing, right? Going back to direct sunlight, maybe you're using some soaps, you got things drying on the surface. This is where the whole washing a car in the garage with a nice warm bucket of Rinseless wash, your favorite music, you light a candle, you zen out, right? It's like you're there, right? And what it did is just slowed me down in my washing process and allowed me to really enjoy it and actually just trust in the chemistry, because I've been Rinseless washing as not just a detailer and an enthusiast, but as a crazy person. I am literally a psychopath. And I've been washing with ONR for almost 8 years now. And jumping to that initial wash was scary, right? Because like many of you, I'm like, I'm probably gonna damage my car.
Yeah.
I'm gonna scratch the snot out of it. The first wash I did was actually a wash in the winter time where my car was covered in a bunch of just nasty muck. And I did the multiple towel method, right, with ONR. I cleaned everything off. I looked, I inspected it with a light, and I said, it's not possible.
Yeah.
I didn't scratch my vehicle. So then the next time I did it, it got easier. Mm-hmm. I got better, I got more efficient, I got faster at it. I've always done a safe wash. I've never induced any damage at all whatsoever. And it's made things less stressful because I can fill up a bucket of ONR. I can bring my car into the garage. I can shut the garage door. I'm spraying minimal amounts of liquid on the surface, right? I'm using wash mitts, towels, whatever I wanna use in the bucket. And I'm only doing a one bucket wash.
Right.
With a grit guard. No two buckets, no nothing.
Saving one time. Bucket.
Dunking my mitt in, dunking my towels in, cleaning things off, drying it all in one step. And I'm like, wow, this is good for my mental health. And I've never induced damage, never, never once. And again, I'm probably crazier than many of you watching. So Rinseless washing, it's changed the way I clean cars. We're always gonna come back to ONR. Many of you are always gonna go back to ONR. When did you start using Optimum No Rinse? Was it this year? Was it 10 years ago? Was it almost 20 years ago when it was first released? We're really curious to hear, so maybe drop a comment down below. And we also wanna know, what product do you wanna see the history of next? Is it another chemical? Is it an accessory? Is it microfiber towels? Whatever it may be, let us know down in the comments because we would love to make that. So as always, if you guys enjoyed this video and love watching the detailing content, please make sure to give us a big thumbs up, subscribe down below for more, and stay tuned for more videos right here at The Rad Company.